Okay, you guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to make different pattern. I hope you guys like it. We're going to need one of blue, the dark blue, and eight of light blue to begin with the pattern. After you get that, you pick up one of dark blue, escape one, pass the needle through the next one. The next one is going to be black, and hopefully I can get it right. See, now light blue, turn around. Dark blue. Light blue. Black. Black. Dark blue, black, light blue. Dark blue, light blue, black. Dark blue, black, light blue, dark blue. Light blue. No, here is gonna be black. Light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Black. Black. Dark blue. Black. Light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Right here is gonna be black. Light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Black. dark blue. Black. Right here is light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Black. Dark blue. Black. Light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Dark blue. right here, like you guys see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. And the next one is going to be 1, 2, 3. So right here is going to be black. Like that. We continue with the light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Black, dark blue. Black. Light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Black. Dark blue. Black. Light blue. dark blue. Black. Light blue. Dark blue, light blue, black, dark blue, black, light blue, dark blue, black, right here is gonna be light blue, dark blue, light blue, black, black, light blue, dark blue, light blue, black. Dark blue. Black. Light blue, dark blue, light blue, dark blue, light blue, dark blue, and right here we're going to begin this heart again over here. It's gonna be this turn, so we're going to get right there the first of that black. Light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Black, dark blue, black. Light blue, dark blue, light blue. black. Dark blue, black, light blue, dark blue, black, light blue, dark blue, light blue, black, dark blue, black, light blue, dark blue, black, light blue, dark blue, light blue, black, dark blue, black, light blue, dark blue. Light blue. Light blue. Black. Dark blue. Black. Light blue. Dark blue, light blue, light blue, dark blue, light blue, dark blue, right here we need to begin this part of the pattern again, right here. So that is going to be black. Light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Black. Dark blue. Black. Light blue, dark blue, light blue, black, dark blue, black, light blue. Light blue. Dark blue. Black. Right here is going to be light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Black. Black, dark blue. Black. Light blue. Dark blue. Black. Light blue. Dark blue. Black. Dark blue. Black. Light blue. dark blue. Light blue. Black. Dark blue. Black. Light blue. Dark blue. Light blue. Like you guys see, I'm using the CBs that they didn't have the same size. So the pattern is gonna come out really bad, very bad shape, like you guys see. But do not worry, because you guys going to use the right size. So just follow the pattern, that's all you need to do. Fit my ring, because like I said, these CBs are totally all over the place. So I have no idea if they're gonna fit or not. Now we're gonna try to close it. So I'm going up this way through this one, and I am going down to this one right here like that. So right here I'm gonna make a knot, because I want to finish this churn without problems. I think if I didn't make a knot right here, I'm gonna have a problem. So I'm gonna make a knot this way, just to make sure it's going to stay, it's not going to move. And I'm gonna fix that later, obviously. So there is a knot, just like that, put it back down like this. Now it's gonna stay, that is what I want. So I'm going back one, like this, and I return this way, like this. All right, so from here, we're gonna try to close this pattern and hopefully come out right. So we are going from this side, from right to left, on the part that has the seed bead sticking up. The one from outside, let's say that, the one from inside, that's supposed to be this one. Like this, all right? Go up in this one, go through in this one, and go into this one. Like that. And the next one, that will be this one over here. And this other side. But you guys see I'm very bad at doing this thing, so I'm sorry for that. No matter how much I try and I cannot get better on doing this, so I'm sorry for that. Well, I'm just trying to give you guys an idea how to close the ring, and that's it. So, it's going to be next one, going to be this one. Hold on. The thing is, they're very shiny. I have no idea which one is the one who's going to be next. I'm going to get this one. Hopefully I get it right. And then this one, then this one, then this one. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna cut these two so I know what am I supposed to be going, because I have no idea. So I'm gonna cut these ones this much. That way they don't get in my way. All right, pull this seed piece out of my way too. Like this. All right, let's see. So from here, what I'm going to do, I'm going through this one right here. Like that. Like you guys see right there, it's closed. See? So now from here, I'm going up and down. The CB is black, it's very hard for me to see, so I'm sorry for that. Go up like this. And then go down. Like that. It looks like that. Even if they are all over the place, the CBs still make a very nice pattern, don't you think so? See? This one goes out, and then you move your ring around, and this one goes in. Whichever way you want to go, this way or this way, I'm gonna continue this way a couple of more times, like that. And going this way like this. Like this. Then go up this way. Obviously, when you finish with this, your ring is going to be really tight. And it's going to fit really, really nice on your finger. Like that. Then like that. So I'm going this side now because I'm going to fix it right here. Make sure it's secure. So I'm going down this way. Through this one. All of this. Just like that. Like that. Right here, we're going to make a knot. Like that. Then we are going down. Like this. And then we are going up. This way. Like that. Now, to hide these ones, I'm going to try to go like this. Try to go up this way, maybe. Doesn't want to let me in, because remember I have the knot right there, so it's not going to let me do that. I'm going maybe this way. At this point, because I have the thread, which the CB is like about 3 times already, so they're not going to let me do that. But right here it is secure already, so I'm going to return. Like that. Then I'm going down this way. Anyway, since we have the knot right there, when that happens, you do this. You put some glue on it. At this moment, I do not have it right here. So put some glue right there where the knot is. Let it get dry, and then you continue working with your getting your ring much secure, making more knots and stuff. Just like that. Sorry, I'm hitting everything again. It's like this. Then right here, I'm going to make another knot. Just like that. Like I said, if you're going to cut it right there, you put a glue on it. If not, just pass the needle for a couple more CBs and then you can cut it. just like that. And right there, we're gonna cut it. All right, and there you have it. The ring is going to look like that. So, one go in like this, going from right to left, and the other one is from left to right. Just like that. I think it looks very cool, don't you think so? If you have size 10 CBs, you can use it, or size 11. That's up to you. Or you can use size 15 if your eyes are really, really good. Mine are really bad, so I can hardly work with this one, so that's what I'm doing. Well, there you have it. It's going to look like that. Look. And this one, like you guys see, I have to add one more because this size is a bit bigger than this one, so that's why I have to add one more turn. But I think it looks very cool anyway, don't you think so? Well, I hope you guys like as much as I do. Well, thank you very much for watching my videos, and would you please not forget to comment, rate, and subscribe to my channels. I really appreciate that so much.